how ironic is it on Thanksgiving that we can be thankful for our lives?
That driver is alive tonight after crashing through an entire building in Tin City last night in downtown Naples. You could hear it. Mm-hmm. A witness saw the car go airborne into the Naples Winery.
The businesses in Tin City were already damaged in the hurricane, so they were closed. NBC2's Alicia Alonso shows us how this crash sets them back even further.
This driver was going so fast. You can see that they tore through each end of Tin City. You can see the clear hole inside of the winery. And today, the property manager shows us video of the moment the driver tore through.
Store owners at Tin City have been working to reopen for weeks.
We had planned on having a grand opening on December 15th. However, this isn't quite the grand opening that I was anticipating.
Now this crash is setting them back.
We were in the furthest left lane and a car just at least 85, 90 miles an hour. Like, it shook our car, the air from the speed of the car.
Stacy Sylvester watched the speeding driver go through the intersection on Goodlett Frank Road this morning.
Had we been in the middle lane, he would have had no pullback or cognitive awareness to push those brakes, and it would have been a different story today.
You're hearing the car go through the Naples Winery and coming out the other side.
I've seen storefronts hit, but I've never, ever seen anybody go through an entire building. I mean, it's amazing.
Naples police say the driver was taken to the hospital with injuries.
I thought he died. We stood outside literally for over an hour with the cops. We heard the cops. We saw what the cops were like, you know, running around the building. We thought he died.
Whoever came through here, man, got lucky because they missed trees. They missed pylons. I mean, it's just amazing how it even happened.
Management says they're hopeful reopening Tin City can stay on track.
Everybody's still in shock because we were so close. You know, we're a couple weeks away. So they're all obviously in shock about this. The damage is done, and now we just have to focus on moving forward and getting it cleaned up and rebuilt as fast as possible.
Reporting local in Naples, Alicia Alonso, NBC2.